Hey, Pens fans, welcome to Pens Den, home of your five-time Stanley Cup champion Pittsburgh Penguins. Pittsburgh Penguins 2017-2018 season recap. All of that in just a minute. Last year, the Penguins celebrated a thrilling Game 7 Eastern Conference Final overtime goal to send them to the Stanley Cup Finals.
Here is all night, either long or short, for one more hero. And we begin. Now it's Sheary. That one came off Stahlberg. It's Schultz working it back in deep. Fresh from the bench, it's Crosby. Crosby on Kunitz, it's shot! Penguins win it! Stick of Chris Kunitz, end over end. Not sure if it goes off of J.G. Pageau. Chris Kunitz with his second of the game. Fresh legs by Crosby.
This year, the Capitals celebrated a thrilling Game 6 Eastern Conference semifinal overtime goal to send them the Eastern Conference final and the Pens to their offseason.
Knocked away. Ovechkin, hands up ice. Kuznetsov! Scores!
And he just pulls the puck from one side of the ice to the other in a beautiful move. Murray can't close it up. And the Washington Capitals finally find a way.
The season started off raising the 2017 Stanley Cup champions banner. Expectations were high for a three-peat. But the best the Pens could be described as for the first few months of the season was lukewarm. Lukewarm play consisted of allowing odd man rushes, defensive breakdowns, abysmal forechecking, and inconsistent power plays. To me, two players who suffered throughout the most of the season were Chris Letang and Matt Murray. Letang had surgery and missed the 2017 playoffs. We were hopeful of seeing him return to his all-star exceptional form. Unfortunately, this was not to be. Many mental mistakes cost the Penguins not only goals but games. And in the midst of the season, his wife suffered a miscarriage. This slide, unfortunately, continued into the playoffs and cost the Pens. Matt Murray was the starter as Marc-Andre Fleury was selected by the Vegas Golden Knights in the expansion draft. Unfortunately, injuries derailed a large part of his season. Plus, he suffered a personal tragedy with the passing of his father. I can't help but think that this affected his play throughout the rest of the season. It's a very tough thing to go through. His sharpness was off, especially with his glove hand, and opponents took advantage of it. He had some stellar games down the stretch, but this was not the Matt Murray of 2017. Phil Kessel, Evgeny Malkin, and Sidney Crosby were on fire the second part of the season. Malkin was a scoring machine. Crosby was putting pucks in the net from almost impossible angles and out of the air, and Kessel had a great scoring touch. General Manager Jim Rutherford saw a need and made a complicated deal involving parting with Ian Cole and Ryan Reeves for Derek Brassard. This was not a popular trade from the get-go, especially parting with one of the best Pens defensemen and the only real muscle the Pens had to help protect their players. What increased the fans' displeasure was that Brassard had a very difficult time adjusting to the Penguins system from the one he played with in Ottawa. The Pens did end up beating the Flyers in the first round. The mistakes were glaring defensively, the goaltending was not sharp, and the offense sputtered at times. A hungry Capitals team awaited them. They were more than ready for the Penguins. They took advantage of the Penguins' lapses in defense and goaltending to win the series 4-2. The series was not without controversy. Disallowed goals, goaltending interference not called, and Zach Aston-Reese getting hit in the head by Tom Wilson, who ended up getting a 3-game suspension. And Zach Aston-Reese suffering a broken jaw and a concussion from this as well. And on the press conference on the clean out the locker room day, there was controversy. General Manager Jim Rutherford said Kessel was playing with an injury but did not require surgery. Head coach Mike Sullivan said he was unaware that Kessel was playing injured. Derek Brassard was playing with a significant injury, groin, that really limited his ability to play. Other injuries were not disclosed per head coach Mike Sullivan. What the Penguins need to do to get back to the form from 2016 and 2017 seasons. Number one, they truly need some rest. They had very short off seasons the past 2 years. Take a few weeks off from anything to do with hockey. Get your headspace cleared. That's for both players and coaches. Chris Letang, take the time off. Simplify your game. Have a better awareness of where you are on the ice at all times. Matt Murray, take the time off. Work on your glove hand. Get a good strength and conditioning coach to help you avoid time on IR. Mentally know that you are number one. Marc-Andre Fleury does not back you up anymore. Rise up and give us games like 2016 and 2017. Phil Kessel, clear your headspace. Get rested. Mark Recchi, is he a right fit behind the bench? Can he get the team energized and ready to play with passion and desire? General Manager Jim Rutherford stated he'll probably make a couple of deals. I see them being deals to obtain some good third or fourth line players or solid defensemen. I don't foresee a major deal coming. We as fans expected them to go out with all cylinders firing against the Caps, but the looks on their faces said they were not going out on all cylinders. We as fans need to rest, recharge, and join with a loud voice in October 2018. It's a hockey night in Pittsburgh. Let's go, Pens.